Hello everyone, welcome or welcome back to my channel. Today I will talk about my Prismacolor pencil collection. I have a lot of different Prismacolors. And yeah, I was thinking maybe we can take a look together about the differences, about the colors. And it might be fun for you if you like all the pencils and pencil talk. So this one is, I think, the Prismacolor Premier pencil that most of you are familiar with. These days, they Prismacolors, when you buy them from the store, you will get them this way. Prismacolor Premier, and then the name, the English name, I think it is a French name, and then the number. If you look closely, you can see Mexico stamped in. So this is the most recent set that I have. I have it in an older box. Let me show you. I have the box with flowers on the cover. I know there is one with a butterfly now, but this is my backup set and I simply restock the pencils when I'm using one of them inside the box. So I'm okay with this one. The reason that I took out this tray is that I want to compare some of the colors together, because I was able to find some older pencils online, and let's dive in and take a look at those color pencils. You might have seen this set already on my channel. It is a wooden box set by Prismacolor, and there are the Sanford Prismacolors inside. And the Sanford Prismacolors are from 1995. I did a lot of research on Prismacolor pencils when I got those pencils at home. So yeah, I found that a lot and I like to share it with you, so I know those pencils were manufactured in 1995. And I know that the neon red color was there for a very limited time. There's also a neon green I have also in my collection. They were made like a few years, so that was what I was able to find about them. Neon green, it's here. And it is a beautiful, beautiful, bright color. So I was able to find some of the other pencils. Some of them I already had. So I owned my Sanford set with pencils already here. And yeah, I have this one. Let me find it. This one. It's different. And let me find this one. To show you the difference between the pencils. I don't know if there's any other difference between them. Those are all from the Canada series, made in Canada, and they don't have the quality issues that we know these days, so those pencils need to be perfect from what I've heard. So yes, let me take out these ones to show you. They started with the manufacturing of Eagle color pencils. The oldest one color pencils that I own is the one with this branding on it. It says Eagle Prismacolor. This is a Canadiana, so I think it's made in Canada and that's why it's on there. Those are very soft and nice. Then the one that I have is also from Canada. It says Barrel Prismacolor. Then we move on to the Prismacolor Sanford. The Barrel one is from 1969 to 1987. they were made in between that time period, and then in 1995 they were creating the ones with the Sanford logo. There's also this one without it, so I think this one is later, but I'm not sure. I have those still unsharpened. And there was a little barcode on them, so you were able to buy them open stock. I know before this one, there are pencils with eagle and then turquoise on it. And those are the really, really old ones. There are also eagles made in the USA. They also are just made before the Canada Eagle pencils. For so far, no. And then they changed it to the Prismacolor. We know these days. The premier line. And now, in between, there is also a period of time they were creating Prismacolor Lightfast pencils. And they were very expensive and not a lot of colorists and artists were buying them. So they were fairly quickly discontinued. The Prismacolors were changing all the time because they were moving owners. I know there were first by Eagle Company, later by the Sanford, by Newell. That's the current owner of the Prismacolors, Newell. And Newell also owns Polygonus pencils. So that's a fun fact that I found out. Between all those years, there were a lot of changing in the colors, and the biggest change was back in 2011 when they changed their 120 color range, as shown in this set, and they changed it to a 150 set, and they took out a lot of colors and added in a bunch of new ones, and that's why there is this huge shifting of colors. I was able to find some of the older colors from before those time periods, and I want to show them. I already picked out one. It is the copper one. There is no color name, and this one is a little bit more heavy because there is real copper inside. It's a beautiful color, and it's a shame that they get rid of it because it will be lovely together. Let me swatch it for you so you can take a look at the real shimmer and shine from the pencil. It feels really strange to color with those very old pencils. Those are soft, crumbly, as you can see, like the Prismacolors that we have these days today. So, you can see it's a very shiny, metallic copper color. And I think it's the best one that we have so far, that I own so far. The best metallic shiny pencil. It is number 951. So if you want to have a look out for them, this is a number. Then I also have some other special pencils. Let me first put them back, otherwise they will roll off my desk and I won't be happy with it when it's happening. I don't want to break my pencils. And then I want to talk about some discontinued old colors, some special colors that I found out, and but sure, it is different, but I don't know. Because they discontinued the lavender color. This is the lavender color that we all know by Prismacolor. And they change it to, I think, Orbit. And you can see there is already a color difference between the ones that I owned. This is the Premier one. And this one is the Sanford one. And you can see there is more blue pigment in the older one compared to the recent one. I don't own any of the new colors, but I think it is very interesting to take a look at the numbers. It is this one. This is also a lavender one. So place it here and you can see it's back to the Premier color. This one is by Beryl Prisma. And now I found this one. And it is also called Lavender. It got an other number. It is 5 to 6. And if you compare it, it is not even close to it. And I think that is very strange and funny. Then I have also the lilac. It's the number 5 and 956. So let me, oops. Then the recent lilac. There is really not that much different. And then I also have the same number, lilac, by Beryl. And it feels a little harder. And you can see it is more blue. I hope you can see. You can really see the difference. So I'm guessing that the new colors are closer to the older pencils compared to the newer ones. You can see this one is really a strange one. I've never seen it before. This lavender 526, so I think it's a special one by Eagle, made in Canada. I'm happy with it in my collection. Then I have something new, special. It is a very rare color. It is 970. And this color is called Orchid. And I know the replacements of one of the colors, like the lavender or the lilac color. The new one is called Orchid. But the old Orchid color is way more purpley, reddish purple. You can see there is no color name on it. It's a special one. It's hard to find, and I was lucky enough to find it in a lot on eBay where they were selling Schoolart pencils. That's why I'm able to get it and not someone else was buying it, because I got the Schoolart range. You can see some of the older ones, old Prismacolor ones, those are a little harder. I think those, yeah, I don't know, are nice. And inside that lot, there were the Prismacolor barrel ones and some of the Eagle ones. And that was so much fun to find out. I like to show you something that was also from the Prismacolor family, because they were sold and got new owners, and a lot is changing. Let me first put some of the pencils back. I don't want to have trouble with them finding them again. And they were making Charisma color pencils. They still got the same number system as the Prismacolors. Let me move away this big box. I have several sets of them, different sizes, different colors inside. This is the 108 set. It's a cardboard box. And those pencils are so buttery soft. Have the same numbering system as the Prismacolors. Well, let me find the purple ones. And move the box out of the way. And they have the same colors as the Prisma. Oh, yes, as the Prismacolors. This is light violet. So I think this light violet color, it is called 956, is the same as the lilac-y color. So you really cannot see a lot of difference in the pencils, but this is one that got renamed. That's fun to see. I didn't notice it before, but there we go. And then I also have the lavender color. Still got the same color number, 934. And it is very close. I think there is no difference between them. No, there's no difference between those. Those are soft, those are nice, and you still can see those are made by Barrel. Got the same little logo, and yes, it shows on top, on the back of the pencil. Those are made in the USA by Barrel and called Charisma Colors. So those are also belonging in the family of the Prismas, but they, yeah, had a little sidetrack, I think. From the companies, from the owners, and those are very nice pencils. I like them more than my Prismacolors, but they are not longer made, so yeah, I'm not using them in my coloring pages. It's a shame, I know, but I like to treasure them and pet them, and yeah. I hope you enjoyed the video. I know it was a little bit chaotic, and yeah, I'm sorry for it, but there is a lot of information that I want to talk about, and I'm not really have it clear on my mind, and I'm looking at this bright purple color, and it looked like the orchid color, and oh no, it's different, so no, no, nothing said there. I hope you enjoyed it. If you want to learn more about the company, you can take a look at Wikipedia. I think there's a lot of information about when they changed owners and packaging, and when they changed the color range and pigments inside of the pencils. So if you are interested in it, you can take a look at it. I hope you enjoyed the video. Thank you for watching, and I really hope to see you next time. Bye!